Elvis's co-star in the motion picture Paradise of Hawaiian Style, Miss Marion Cocke, way over there. Honey, I can't reach that far, but you know, we love you. And she was Elvis's private nurse and so forth, and friend too, I'll put that in there. But Suzanna Leigh, honey, you were in Paradise of Hawaiian Style. First of all, let's talk about your book there.
Oh, thank you, George. Yes, Paradise Suzanna Style, which is a take.
Show the cover of that. Okay, very good.
Yes, it's here at the library, and you can get it on Amazon. It was very exciting for me to make an Elvis movie.
I bet it was.
Oh, it was huge, because I was English, for a start, and I was a huge Elvis fan. And I always remember the first time Elvis and I were under contract to Hal Wallace. And I just made a film called Boeing Boeing with Tony Curtis. And I was sitting in the commissary with Hal, and he said, now, before anything else happens, I'm going to send you and Elvis to Hawaii for a couple of months. I went, wow. And he said, you're not an Elvis fan, are you? And I said, well, sort of. And yeah, it was just awesome. He was such an
But you worked with Tony Curtis, and you also worked with the comedian Jerry Lewis. How did Elvis compare on the movie sets?
Oh, well, totally different, really. I mean, Jerry Lewis and Tony. Tony I worked with a few times and was very professional and hugely great actor. And in that respect, he was very similar to Elvis, because Elvis was a very underrated actor. But he also had this photographic memory, as you know.
Yes, he did.
And he could look at a script, even if they changed it last night, and he would know your lines, everybody's lines, and now that's an art.
That's great. Suzanna Leigh, honey, you have a story about the Queen of England. I'm going to come back to you in just a moment.
Okay.
But Mrs. Cocke, tell the people out there watching today how you hooked up with Elvis Presley.
Well, I was supervisor of a nursing floor at Baptist Hospital, and actually had all of the patients from the group of doctors that Dr. Nicopoulos worked with. And so he came up one day and told me that Elvis was sick and he needed to bring him in the hospital. And would I have the suite available? And I said I would. And I called a lady down in admissions and said, Sarah, we're gonna hold this suite that we had somebody special coming in. I told her who it was, but don't breathe a word. And so she knew that I meant that. But anyway, he came in, and you know, the chemistry was just there between us, George. But I actually told Dr. Nick, I said, I'm off the day he's coming in. And Dr. Nick said, well, you know, this is Elvis Presley. Would you please come in and stay with him that day? And I said, Dr. Nick, I don't get but 2 days a week. And he said, well, if you won't do it for Elvis, do it for me. And I said, okay, I'll do it for you. So I went in the next day, and of course, as soon as I looked at him and he looked at me, we just went together.
Like chemistry was there.
Almost,
huh?
Like peanut butter and banana sandwich.
Yeah.
And so later on, when Joe and the guys got ready to leave, Joe said, we're going to have to talk about private duty nurses for you. And Elvis said, nah, I'm going to talk to Miss Cocke first. And that afternoon, he brought it up himself, yeah. And he said, what do you want me to do about nurses? And I said, honey, that's up to you, whatever you want to do. And he said, well, if you want me to have a private duty nurse, I will, but I want you to be the one that takes care of me.
Well, what a
and
job.
And I said, then you don't need a private duty nurse.
Excuse me, but you've got a book there. I want to plug the book before we let you go.
You know, George, this didn't start out to be a book. It started out to be my memories only for me, so that when I got too old to remember, like now, that I've passed 39, I could pull those notes out and read them.
Yeah.
And Vernon wanted to read them. And when I showed them to him, he said, please have this published.
Show that book on camera, honey.
And he said, please have this book published.
I called him Babe, and where it's
called
available?
Called him Babe, and it's available, actually, you can email me or call me.
Okay.
And it's in some of the stores. It's at, I don't know, different places in town here, and Graceland also carries it. But I'm in the phone book.
Okay, Marion Cocke, C-O-C-K-E.
It's listed as Robert in the phone book.
Excuse me, but Suzanna Leigh, we're short on time. Tell the story about the Queen of England. I'm sorry, Miss Cocke.
Well, in England, the big honor is to be presented to the Queen. And I have a photograph, obviously. And it was very exciting, you know. You're standing in the lineup, and whether it's the Queen or the President of America or whoever, You're always very nervous, George. Oh, you know, you're thinking, what are they going
she's
to say?
Great.
So she comes along and we talk for a few minutes, and then she says, now tell me all about Elvis Presley.
The Queen said that.
And so she then said that would he like to come to England? And I said, oh, she would, Your Majesty. He would, definitely. And so she did send an invitation, but she sent it to the Colonel. Not to
oh yeah, well, you know how that works.
Yes.
Suzanne, we got to run. You're the best, Miss Cocke, honey. We love you, and we'll be at your banquet this coming year, and so forth, and so we'll be everywhere with you during this month. Okay.
I hope so. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Suzanna Leigh, co-star of Elvis's motion picture, Paradise Hawaiian Style. Mrs. Marion Cocke, Elvis's private nurse, and more than that, very close friend and confidant. I'm George Klein. It's Memphis Sounds.